So the next point is fixing up of signatories. This is the fourth function of the promoter. Fixing up of signatories. Now what happens is that the memorandum of association is to be signed by the first directors of the company. Now the promoters have to decide that who will sign the memorandum of association. Memorandum of association is the charter of the company. We will discuss about it later on. It is the most important document of the company, which defines the objectives of the company. So the promoters only decide who will sign the memorandum of association. Usually those who sign the MOA become the first director of the company. So the next function is to decide the signatories to MOA. The next function is appointment of professionals. The fifth function. Appointment of professionals. Now, promoters are not professionals. It's not necessary that they are professionals. Like in our example, Ram was an engineer. He probably would not have any knowledge about how a company should be formed because he is from a different stream of education. So in that case, he need to appoint some professionals to guide him in the formation of the company. So professionals like chartered accountants, bankers, auditors are appointed by the promoters who will assist the promoters in the formation of the company. So appointment of professionals like bankers, auditors, chartered accountants are appointed to assist the promoters in the formation of the company. And the last function is preparation of necessary documents. Sixth function. Preparation of necessary Now there are various documents that have to be prepared. Documents like MOA, Memorandum of Association, AOA, Article of Association, we will discuss them all in detail. These have to be prepared by the promoters. So their next function is to prepare these documents before the company is formed. This is the sixth and the last function of the promoter. So these are the six functions of the promoter. Let's quickly revise so that we can memorize them. First is identification of opportunity. This is the first function of the promoter. Next is feasibility study. We have discussed about TEF, technical feasibility study, economical feasibility study, and financial feasibility study. So this is the second function of promoter. Third function is to get the name approved from the registrar of companies. So, name approval. Next function, the fourth function is fixing up of signatories who will sign the memorandum of association. So, this is the next function. Fifth function is appointment of professionals like bankers, auditors, who will help them in formation of the company. This is the next function. And the last function, the sixth function, is preparation of necessary documents. So these are the six functions of promoters of a company. Now let's discuss about documents to be prepared by the promoters. We know that the promoters have to prepare the documents, but what are those documents? What all do those documents contain? So preparation of necessary documents. Preparation of documents. Now, the first document is MOA, Memorandum of Association. I've already said it is the charter documents. It is the most important document. It contains the objectives of the company. So, Memorandum of Association. It is called as MOA in short. So it is the charter of the company. And it contains the objectives. The company. Now, it is formed in a manner, it contains various clauses within it. Memorandum of Association contains clauses inside it. The first clause is the name clause. So, let's discuss what are the clauses in the MOA one by one. So, clauses. The first clause is the name clause. Name clause, as the name suggests, it contains the name of the company. Now, promoter has already done his function of getting the name approved. So, now he has the name for the company. So, in this clause, the name of the company which has been approved by the registrar of company is mentioned. So, this is the first and the foremost clause. The second clause is the object clause. Object. The name itself suggests object clause contains the objectives of the company. So this is the second clause in the Memorandum of Association, object clause, which contains the objective for which the company is formed, the purpose for which the company is formed. But this has been further classified into two, main object and other objects. So it has two sub clauses inside it, that is main object and other object. This is the second clause having two sub-clauses inside it. Third clause is the registered office clause. Registered office clause. This clause contains the address of the company where it will have its registered office. So this is the third clause, registered office clause. A fourth clause is the liability clause. Liability clause. Now a company can have various kinds of liability of its members. It can have a limited liability. It can have unlimited liability of its members. So this clause contains that what kind of liabilities will the members have. Whether they will have a limited liability, whether they will have an unlimited liability. So this clause specifies about the liability of the members. And the last clause is the capital clause. It contains the details of the capitals of the company. It contains the authorized capital of the company. Authorized capital is that capital which is a maximum capital up to which a company is authorized to issue capital. So that is the capital clause. It contains the details of authorized capital of company. So these are the five clauses in the Memorandum of Association. It is the charter document. It contains the name clause, which contains the name which has been approved by the ROC. Second is the object clause. It contains the objectives of the company. It has two sub clauses, main object and other objects. Third clause is the registered office clause. It contains the registered address of the company. Fourth is the liability clause. It contains the information about the liability of the members, that is whether they will have a limited liability, unlimited liability or guaranteed liability. This clause is the fourth clause, and the last clause is the capital clause. It contains the authorized capital of the company. This is the first document which the promoter needs to prepare. The second document is the Articles of Association. Articles of Association. It contains the rules regarding the internal management of the company. MOA is a broader concept. AOA is a narrower concept than MOA. AOA is Articles of Association. We can write here that it is also called AOA in short. Articles of Association has rules regarding internal management of the company. we should remember that it is subsidiary to the memorandum of association. This means that there cannot be any clause in the articles which is contradictory to memorandum of association. It is subordinate to MOA. It can never contradict the MOA. So any clause which is contradictory to a clause in memorandum is void. That means it has no effect. It will not be valid. So it is subsidiary to MOA. Subsidiary to memorandum of association. Now, a public limited, this is the articles of association. It has been provided in the Companies Act an option for the public limited company. Every public limited company has an option not to prepare its article of association and to adopt Table A. Table A has been provided in the Companies Act, which is like articles of association. So a company which does not want to prepare its own AOA, it can use that Table A as its AOA. That means that that company can follow the rules mentioned in the Table A. Basically, AOA contains the rules regarding management. So Table A also contains the rules regarding management. A public limited company can adopt Table A and not prepare its own article of association. So this is the option available only with a public limited company. So a public limited company can adopt Table A. Table A, it is called Table A. It is there in the Companies Act. It has various rules. So this is option only for public limited company and not for any other company. So this is the second document, Articles of Association. Let's take the third document. The third document is Consent of Proposed Directors. Written consent of the proposed directors has to be prepared. The proposed directors have to give a written consent that they agree to act as the directors and they agree to take up the qualification shares. So, written consent for what? For one, to act as directors, and second, to take up the qualification shares. Qualification shares is basically the minimum number of shares that a director needs to take in a company. It has been provided so that every director has some interest in the company, so that he works for the good of the company. If a director will have shares in the company, he becomes the owner of the company, and in that case he will work with total honesty towards the company. That is why a clause has been made that a director should be compulsorily required to take up qualification shares in the company. So this is the third document, that director's consent has to be taken in written, that they agree to act as directors of the company and they agree to take up the qualification shares of the company. The fourth one is agreement. Now the company might enter into agreement with any individual to act as managing director or whole time director. In such cases also the agreement should be prepared. So any agreement which a company enters with an individual, only an individual can be the director of the company. So any agreement which the company enters with an individual to act as a managing director, MD, managing director, all whole time director, WTD should also be prepared. So any agreement between a company and an individual should be prepared where the individual agrees to be the managing director or the whole time director of the company. The fifth document is statutory declaration. A declaration that all these requirements which we have discussed so far have been complied with. That all the rules made for the formation of the company have been complied with by the promoters to their best. So, statutory declaration that legal requirements complied, that all the legal requirements have been complied. Now this document, the statutory declaration, has to be signed. It has to be signed by any of the five persons. The first person is an advocate of High Court or Supreme Court. So either it can be signed by advocate of High Court or Supreme Court. It can be signed by a chartered accountant in practice. He has to be in practice. So the second option is CA in practice. Third option is to get it signed by the director named in the articles of association. So any director can also sign it. Fourth is the manager can also sign the declaration. The manager named in the articles of association. So a manager. And the last one is the secretary named in the articles of association. The company secretary named in the articles. They will sign that they have agreed that the legal requirements have been complied. They will check whether all the requirements have been complied. So this is the fifth document, statutory declaration. Last is payment of fee. Now a proof of the fact that the fee has been paid has also to be prepared. Now fee depends on the authorized capital of the company. To form a company, one has to pay a fee. That fee depends on authorized capital. Of the company. So a proof that the fee for the registration of the company has been paid. So these are the six documents that are to be prepared. Now let's discuss, let's revise all these six points with the help of Avdhan. since there are 6 points, we have used a hexagon here to remember that it has 6 points. So, what are we learning? The documents that are to be prepared by the promoters. The first document was MO. So, the first is MOA. Second one is AOA, Article of Association. The third document was Consent of Proposed Directors. So the third one is Consent. The fourth one is the Agreement. Fifth is Statutory Declaration. And sixth is Payment of Fee. So these are the 6 documents: MOA. The first is MOA, second is AOA, third is Consent, fourth is Agreement, fifth is Statutory Declaration, sixth is Payment of Fee. Now this is a Avdhan. We have used a hexagon. It is a standard for 6 points. It is always read clockwise. So we have written all the points in the same sequence as they were given: MOA, AOA, Consent, Agreement, Statutory Declaration and Payment of Fee. These are the 6 documents.